Today we're going to see how to play a song on a membrane keypad using this musical Arduino. The inspiration for this video was the push-button touch-tone phone, which I had as a child. And you pick up the handset of that phone and you could press buttons to dial a phone number, and each number had a different tone to it. And you could press those in a certain order to play a song. And in fact, if you weren't careful, you could find yourself calling a foreign country. But it was fun, and I did it often. In fact, someone even published a music book on how to play different songs on your phone. And anyway, that's where this comes from. And in fact, that's what we're going to do today. We're going to play a song on our membrane keypad for Arduino. Now, what I'm going to use for today's video is a 4x4 membrane keypad. I'm going to use some mel-to-mel jumpers, and then just an 8-ohm speaker that I soldered the wires to. And then, of course, Arduino Uno or Mega, or whichever Arduino you prefer. If you bought an Arduino kit, chances are pretty good that you have one of these membrane keypads. And the way it works is that this is in layers. On the bottom, you have the adhesive layer. On the top, you have this printed layer with numbers and letters. Under that, you have a metal disc, which you can hear as you depress it. You can hear and feel it pop. Under that, you have a top circuit. Under that, you have a spacing membrane. And under that, you have a bottom circuit. Now, the rows are set up as inputs, and they're held high with an internal pull-up resistor. And the columns are set as outputs, and those are held low. Now, the Arduino will check to see which row has been set to low. And when the row and the column make a connection, it'll know which button has been pressed. For instance, if row 3 has been set to low on column 3, that'll know that 9 has been pressed. Here's a look at the diagram that came with my Elegoo Mega Kit, and I go back to this to help you get a visualization of what I'm talking about. I hope that helps. And since I have the Elegoo Mega file open, we're going to go ahead and use the same wiring diagram. So this is a good picture of it. And what we're going to do is connect from pin 9 to pin 2 from left to right. This will be pin 9. This one will be pin 2. We'll just connect them all. Connect your first one, connect it to pin 9, and then we'll just go ahead and connect the last one to pin 2. And then take your 8-ohm speaker and connect the positive to pin 10, and then your negative to ground. And that's it. Now, my wire is pretty stiff, so I don't need a breadboard. You may have flexible wiring. It's okay to put it in a breadboard. Just connect it to 10 and ground. Here is my code that I used. In line 1, we have the keypad library. In line 2, we have the tone library. This line declares a constant byte named rows, and it's assigned the value of 4, and this represents the number of rows in the keypad. This line declares a constant byte named columns, or COLS, and it's assigned a value of 3, and that represents the number of columns in the keypad. This line declares a two-dimensional array named keys, which stores characters char, and the dimensions of the array are rows by columns, or 4x3, to match the standard phone keypad. And this means the array keys will have 4 rows and 3 columns. And as we look down here, the contents of the array are initialized with the characters of a typical phone keypad, and it's arranged in the standard layout. This line declares an array of bytes called row pins with the size rows. And that's 4 from the previous snippet. You can see it up here. And this array holds the number of Arduino pins that are connected to rows of the keypad. In this case, the rows are connected to Arduino pins 9, 8, 7, and 6. And the same for this line, only this refers to our columns. The columns are connected to Arduino pins 5, 4, and 3. This line creates an instance of the keypad class, which comes from our keypad library. And this class is used to manage the keypad and detect button presses. This line creates an instance of tone class, and that comes from our tone library, and it's to help control the speaker that we connected to the Arduino. Now, this is a two-dimensional constant integer array named notes, which has the number of rows and the number of columns, and they initialize with certain integer values in each row and column. And these numbers down here They are the frequencies of the sounds that should be played when each key is pressed. These frequencies are measured in hertz, and I try to get it so that the distribution among the buttons would be similar to that of a telephone, so you may have to do some adjusting if it doesn't sound quite right. Now here in our setup, we initialize the serial monitor at 9600 baud, and here we initialize our speaker that's plugged into Arduino pin 10. Now we're at our loop, and I like to think of the loop as telling a story. This line calls the getKey method from the keypad object, KPD, that was created earlier, and it checks if the key has been pressed on the keypad. If a key is pressed, then the code inside these brackets will be executed. These lines declare two integer variables, row and column, and initializes them to minus one, and these will be used to store the row and column of the pressed key. Now in this section, you'll see two for loops, and these are used to iterate over each row and column in the keys array, which represents the keypad. And if the pressed key matches the key in the array, it sets row and column to the location of the matched key, and it breaks out of the loop. If a match was found inside the keys array, then the code inside the brackets will be executed. Now these lines print the message to the serial monitor showing which key has been pressed. And this line gets the corresponding frequency from the notes array using the row and column values, and this frequency is stored in the variable note. And this line plays the tone corresponding to the frequency stored in note for a duration of 120 milliseconds. And that's it for our code. And now we have our code ready, so we're going to go ahead and upload this to our board. So go up here and click upload. Once it's done, we should be able to push the buttons and hear a tone. All right, so it's done. And in our code, since we only used three columns right here in this line, we don't have any tones over here. So it'd be just like a real telephone. But you could add another column and then get these to work. It's just a matter of putting it in the code. So Mary had a little lamb. Thank you all very much for watching. I do appreciate it. If you enjoyed the video, be sure to like and subscribe and share it with somebody else who might enjoy it. I'll see you again soon. Thank you.